have heard, if you've been watching the international news, there is a crisis in Spain, okay? And here's the deal. Last Friday, the Catalan parliament declared independence from Spain. They are completely independent, but will now move into Spain's basement and still be asked to borrow the car. Well, since then, the football has really hit the fan. Spain has jailed 8 of the top members of the Catalan government, issued an arrest warrant for its leader, who is in exile in Belgium. Meanwhile, the prime minister of Spain declared, "I have decided to call free, clean, and legal elections to restore democracy, because nothing says democracy like jailing everyone the people elected." Now, Spain finds itself at a boiling point. So what do Catalans want in their independence? Why is Spain so against it? And most importantly, what is Catalonia? Isn't that the maid in To Kill a Mockingbird? We answer those questions in the exciting debut and conclusion of my one-part series, Spanked Misbehavin'.
Ole!
It was either that or, oh no, you Madridin'. Which we evidently should have gone with. Catalans, which is why you call people from Catalonia, Catalans feel unique because they have their own language, their own culture, and laws that are unlike anywhere else in the country. Kind of like Florida, but without the shirtless guys going through the drive-thru while on fire. Catalans even have their own distinct cuisine with dishes like coca de mollador, because evidently, Catalans invented bagel bites. The Catalans also pronounce it Barcelona. Well, the rest of Spain keeps saying Barcelona. And frankly, Catalans are thick of it. Catalonia was independent at one time. It was part of the Kingdom of Aragon, but in the 15th century, King Ferdinand of Aragon married Queen Isabella of Spain and united their kingdoms. They were so excited, they sent Christopher Columbus to show Native Americans how fun it is to be part of Spain. His housewarming gift? Smallpox. And ever since then, being under Spanish rule has chafed the Catalans like spangly pants on a sweaty matador. These are quite tight. This matador comes pre-gored, evidently. In the 1930s, Spanish dictator Francisco Franco, still dead, tried to destroy Catalan separatism, killing thousands and exiling thousands more. He suppressed music and even dancing. For more details, just watch Footloose with these Spanish subtitles on. Nowadays, Catalonia is an economic powerhouse that resents the propping up of the rest of Spain. It accounts for nearly a fifth of Spain's economy, producing 25% of its exports. So Catalans feel overtaxed and underrepresented by a country that still has an actual king, Felipe VI. That's right, the sixth. Not only is Spain overtaxing them, they're hogging all the Felipes. And now here we are. Spain is not going to back down, vowing to impose direct rule, with one analyst saying the state may be willing to go to war to preserve it. Listen, Catalonia, America has no desire to get into the middle of a civil war, if you don't count Iraq, Afghanistan, Syria, and Kardashian. But we Americans do know a thing or two about ditching a monarchy that's taxing you unfairly to start a new country. Trust us, it is going to take courage, it will take determination, and a whole lot of stupid wigs. The rest is really complex.